Tonight we're dealing with a very serious public safety issue. Two cases of a man disguised as a police officer preying on young women walking alone. The first assault happened on Saturday afternoon in Fridley. A woman walking to her vehicle in the 6400 block of 5th Street Northeast told police the man kidnapped her, sexually assaulted her, and then let her go. About 13 hours later and 8.5 miles away, there was a second assault. We told you about this one last night. This time it was on the University of Minnesota campus. Well, tonight our Jay Coles is live in Fridley. And Jay, how are people there reacting to this?
Well, you know, Leah, they're a little bit on edge. You can see behind me there's a very large apartment complex. Right behind it is another apartment complex, all with big parking lots. Next to those is a public library with a big parking lot. There's a government center with a big parking lot. And remember this now, the suspect did this very brazenly, did it in the middle of the day, and he was right across the street from the Fridley Police Department.
This is not the place you'd expect a guy pretending to be a police officer, kidnapping, and then sexually assaulting a woman. But it did happen here, in a Fridley parking lot, in the middle of the day.
My heart is pounding right now, like, whoa, what is going on? This is supposed to be the police? They're impersonating?
Flashing a police badge, identifying himself as an officer, as he assaults a woman where dozens of families live.
I am, like, shocked that I haven't heard anything about this, and what is going on?
All police know is the same type of sexual assault occurred in Minneapolis near the east bank of the U of M early Sunday morning. Similar MO. A guy pretended to be an officer driving a black SUV, showed a badge, lured a woman inside, and then sexually assaulted her. The worst fear any parent of a college student has. Enough of a worry that some want their children prepared to fight back.
I have two daughters, and they're that college age, and so I had them take a self-awareness defense class with the police department.
Karen Jolly tells us her daughters thought mom was overreacting, but now think mom was exactly right.
I'm really glad they did it. I mean, you always kind of worry about will they be able to do it when the time happens, but at least I know they have the tools to do it if it should happen.
Now, investigators are looking for a black male in his mid-20s with a medium build and a neatly trimmed chin strap type of beard. Now, the black SUV he's driving also has a computer mounted on the center console. So if you have any information, Minneapolis police should be contacted or the Anoka County Sheriff's Office. Reporting live in Fridley, Jay Coles, 5 Eyewitness News.
And on the U of M campus, students have actually been warned in 8 separate crime alerts this year, and 5 came just this month alone. The warnings range from robberies and attempted robberies now to the sexual assault. Police say there is a simple step that you can take if somebody stops you and tries to identify themselves as a police officer.
Get on your cell phone, call 911, ask, and let the person know that that's what you're doing. The dispatcher then can find out on the air if that, in fact, that person is a valid police officer.
And Commander Falcons adds that if that person is not an officer, dispatch would at least be able to track your whereabouts and send you help. Later in our newscast, we're going to meet a woman who is now using her own story of being attacked to help empower other women. A man stabbed Angela Champagne Frum as she walked from her office to a downtown Minneapolis parking ramp in April of last year. Well, she fought back against that man. And before he ran off, he told her, "You're lucky you're a fighter."
I personally think it's a positive thing. Like, I'm lucky I'm a fighter. That's probably the best compliment that an attacker could give their victim.
Now Angela's teamed up with a self-defense expert to help other women know how to defend themselves. You'll see what they're telling women to do and the one tool, better than mace or even a gun, she says, that women should always carry with them. That is coming up at 10:30 tonight.